Welcome to part two of my 3D screencasting series. In today's episode, you'll learn how to import footage into Adobe After Effects, create a composition of the correct length and time, and then we'll use a very cool technique called rotoscoping to fix discrepancies between our screenshots and our screen footage. Let's get started. So the first thing we need to do is actually import in our Snagit screen captures and Camtasia Studio screen recordings. So we're going to double click on the project bin. We're going to find those assets and bring them in. Now I need to find the screen recording. So it's this AVI that Camtasia created. And we're going to create a new comp by dragging this down onto the new comp icon. And we're going to do Command K to open up the composition settings. We're going to give this a new name. So I've now got this composition, which has got my screen recording in it. See my mouse moving, the changes. Now I want you to pay attention to this taskbar here because we're gonna do something here in the next step, which is bringing this desktop screenshot down below this. And you can see if I solo this desktop, we get these changes in the taskbar, right? So we need to fix that. And the way we'll do that is just by duplicating this desktop. So I'm going to hit Command-D, and I'm going to bring that icon up above. I will solo it. I will go and grab my pen tool. I'm going to quickly rotoscope out the portion of the taskbar that we want. So we could be more precise, but this is just quick and dirty. And you can see now I'm just seeing this visible area of the taskbar. The rest of this black area is actually all transparent. So if I unsolo that, you'll notice that now I've got this nice screen recording with the appropriate taskbar. So a little fix there, and we're just gonna, for organization's sake, pre-comp these things. So I'll select those two layers, I'll come up to layer, and I'll choose pre-compose. We'll give this a name, say okay.
Hey, thanks for watching. You just got a little taste of how easy and powerful rotoscoping can be, but we've only just begun our journey. So make sure you tune in tomorrow for the next episode where we'll learn how to use rotoscoping to combine a transparent window frame with screen video. I'll see you then.